Hello guys, this is Raven from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 194. Microsoft's been a busy tech giant lately. Not only is the company working on Windows 11, which makes its debut on October 5th, but it's got a ton of hardware in the works powered by a new operating system. Microsoft showed off its latest hardware on September 22nd. Microsoft unveiled new 2-in-1 devices highlighted by the Surface Laptop Studio, a hinged laptop that will convert into a portable tablet. And Microsoft is taking another stab at the dual-screen phone as well, introducing a Surface Duo 2. Please check out the card above or the link present in the description to know more about the Microsoft products. Realme GT Neo 2 price in China started around ₹28,000. This phone features a 120Hz AMOLED display, 65W fast charging support and a Snapdragon 870 processor. Realme GT Neo 2 India launch has been teased. It may launch in India in the next few weeks. Realme cordless vacuum cleaner has been teased on Flipkart. It has a handheld vacuum cleaner that will come with a 140W motor. It may launch with other Realme products on September 24th. Realme is going to announce its new version of its UI, the Realme UI, which will be unveiled. Realme UI was first announced in 2019 when Realme decided to drop Oppo's ColorOS for its own custom UI. It followed it up with the Realme UI 2.0 in September 2020, which its phones currently run and it is based on Android 11. Now that Android 12 is almost here, Realme is set to announce a new UI that will be based on a new version of Android. Redmi 32-inch and a 43-inch smart TVs have been launched in India. The smart TV shipped with a dual-band Wi-Fi Android 11 TV OS with Patchwell 4.0 UI and 20W speaker with DTS and Dolby Audio. Redmi 32-inch smart TV prices for ₹15,999, while the 43-inch model cost us around ₹25,999. Xiaomi today announced that it will be introducing the new CV series smartphones on September 27th in China at 2 PM Chinese time. The CV series is set to replace the Xiaomi CC lineup, and with the event still 5 days away, we will hopefully learn more about the CV smartphones in the lead up to the announcement. Oppo F19s will launch in India on September 27th. Ahead of this launch, the pre-booking offers have been revealed. This upcoming offering will be the fourth device in the F19 series. Chinese online retailer revealed the Oppo K9 Pro will be launching in China on September 26, and the date is now officially confirmed by the Oppo, as it took to Weibo to announce the K9 Pro's launch event will begin in China on Sunday at 5 PM on Chinese time. The Department of Telecommunication has initiated a set of reforms that enable contactless and secured authentication for mobile subscribers in the country. This means you can now get a new mobile connection online, get the SIM delivered at your doorsteps, the convert mobile connection from prepaid to postpaid, or complete the process of know your customer KYC at the comfort of your home. The move from the DOT is part of the telecom reforms approved by the cabinet on September 15th. The world is facing a shortage of semiconductors at this moment. This has affected various industries across the globe, including the automobile, consumer electronics and others. The lack of chips has led the car makers halting production, while the electronic industry growth has also been stunned. According to the research, the lead times for chips has risen again and reached 21 weeks last month. A group of Cambodian students have designed a prototype drone that they hope can eventually be used to ferry people around Phnom Penh and even help fight fires. With 8 propellers and using a school chair for the pilot seat, the drone was developed by students at the National Polytechnic Institute of Cambodia on the outskirts of the capital. The drone, when we see it flying without a pilot, there is a lot of shaking. The drone, when we see it flying without a pilot, there is a lot of shaking. But when a pilot sits on it and fly, it becomes more stable and feels so excited. The European Commission on Thursday is expected to present a legislative proposal for smartphones, tablets and electronic devices to have a common charging port to prevent accumulation of e-waste, a move that would drastically affect Apple and its proprietary lighting port on iPhones. The European Union has been pushing to bring a common charger for devices for over a decade with an intention to not just save the environment but also make it convenient for users. Lithuanian government found Xiaomi Mi 10T 5G having built-in censorship capabilities. Huawei P40 was also found sending user data to sensors in Singapore. The cybersecurity authorities did not find any security flaw in the OnePlus smartphones. iPhone 14 series are expected to launch in the second half of 2021. iPhone 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max are said to come with a punch-hole display. iPhone 13 mini reportedly will be replaced by a 6.7-inch iPhone 14 Max model. iPhone 13 mini tipped to be the last mini iPhone. Apple will drop the mini model from 2022's iPhone 14 lineup. Tipster cites iPhone 12 mini's poor sales performance for this decision. Honor had launched its latest Honor Tab V7 Pro tablet in the home country. It went on sale on the same month it was announced, and now the company is all set to launch a watered-down model of the same. Honor has scheduled a product launch event named Honor Smart Life on 26 September, and the company will be unveiling several new products at the same event. Among others, the company has confirmed to launch Honor Tab V7. Pokemon Unite is now available to download on mobile, though it won't officially be playable until the servers go back online at 2 AM CT on September 22nd. This means any players that pre-registered the game or just want to download it can search for Pokemon Unite in the Apple App Store or Google Play Store to find the game available. Zee Entertainment Enterprises Limited on Wednesday announced a merger with Sony Pictures Network India. After the merger, Sony will invest $1.57 billion and will be the major shareholder with a 52.93% controlling stake. The shareholders of Zee Limited meanwhile will hold a 47.07% stake. The merger was approved by Zee Limited board and said that which Punit Goenka will remain the managing director and the CEO of the merged entity.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.